three stages of the ice dancing have different requirements and are differently marked. Point two is given to the winner of each compulsory dance, which together are worth 20% of the total marks. The winner of the original dance is given point six, 30% of the marks. And the winner of the free dance gets one, 50% of the marks. And in the event of a tie, it's the free dance which decides. The Starlight Waltz was the first compulsory test for Jane Torvill and Christopher Dean on their return to competitive skating. The steps laid down, the music chosen by the governing body. The other compulsory at the British Championships in Sheffield, drawn from four possible dances, was the blues, for which they chose the slowest beat permitted. The marks, and many an expert opinion, suggested that in their first compulsories for 10 years, time had stood still. By chance, the first compulsory in the European Championships in Copenhagen was the Paso Doble, the same as in their Olympic victory year in Sarajevo 10 years ago. Spot which performance is now and which then. The length of Jane's hair seems the only obvious giveaway. But the judges in Copenhagen didn't like their performance. It was a major shock when the Swiss gave only 5.2 and the Austrian placed them no higher than fourth, a lesson for the coming Olympics. In 1984, the original dance had a set pattern, now no longer the case, and Torvill and Dean used the required repetition in a stunning manner for a performance that many felt surpassed even their free programmes. In this Olympic year, the original dance is the rumba. The rhythm laid down, but the music and the interpretation, the choice of the skaters. In Copenhagen, Jane and Chris's version won them the European title. The majority of the judges were in accord with the crowd. They moved into first place, and that was to prove vital. Every follower of skating has a favourite T&D free dance. For some, it's Mac and Mabel, a freewheeling extravaganza which hid its difficulty. For others, Barnum, which further pushed back the boundaries of ice dancing, a circus act on ice. And then came the drama of the bolero, which won them their Olympic crown. The trouble was, it set a trend which few had even the ability to try to copy. The holds became more complicated. The whole style of ice dancing increasingly intense. To pose seemed as important as to skate, with the costumes becoming ever more theatrical. Ice dancing's governing body cried enough and rewrote the rules to return ice dancing to the ballroom. The challenge for Torvill and Dean couldn't have come at a better time, a new opportunity to set the trend. And for all their problems in Copenhagen, they remain intent on proving that when you face the music, they are still the ones who can best dance. Watch for the changes in their program.
And the ice dance competition begins this evening with the two compulsory dances which were drawn a couple of days ago. They are to be the Blues, which Jane and Chris performed at both the British and European Championships, and the Starlight Waltz, another of the dances from Copenhagen last month.
Well, Jane and Chris are back on the ice practicing this morning. Their practice session yesterday showed a few rough edges to their free dance, but today they were working on the compulsories that they'll be performing tonight. First, that Starlight Waltz, and this is a piece of music you'll hear a few times tonight. Pretty effortless to my untrained eye, and Jane and Chris seemed fairly relaxed about things. Smattering of British support, even for this practice session at the Harmar Auditorium. Then Jane and Chris went to work on the Blues.
Practice is over. The next time it's for real, and we're all looking forward to that.
Good luck to them. One more reminder that we're on earlier than billed tomorrow night, 7:25 BBC Two tomorrow. That's in order to do justice to Stephen Cousins in the men's free programme. But tonight, on air at 6 o'clock to start the build-up to Jane Torvill and Christopher Dean's compulsories. We'll see them live on the ice at around 7 o'clock. Bye for now.